You're in some great company with Taylor Swift and Tim McGraw, that song, that first single, Dina Carter and Strawberry Wine. Yeah. And so I'm like, yeah, let's, like, that's right. You take that ballad to radio and, like, do it all the way, you know?
I mean, if I could even get close to what they did, that'd be insane.
Have there been any super memorable moments on stage in the last few months touring with these guys?
Yeah, you know, my first real major large tour was with Cole Swindell and Travis Denning. And when I tell you, Cole Swindell is the nicest human. I don't think I've ever met somebody more real in the industry, like truly. And I've met a lot of amazing people, so that says something. But he brought me out every single night on that tour to sing Man, I Feel Like a Woman and Never Say Never with him. And just every night, you know, Ashley Cooke, like, just highlighted me so much, which is, you know, so massive for first of three and a new artist on a tour like that. So every single time I got to go on that stage, it felt unreal. And that's probably the highlight of my entire freaking year, which is saying something because so much has happened. So he just really made me feel so special and, you know, brought me out every single night. So it was really cool.
And Cole's somebody that, I mean, he's not like super loud or like off stage, but on stage, he's just so at home and he's just on, you know? And I think that's fun to watch that transfer. It's like, it's really fun to get to, in when you're in those slots, sit side stage and just like watch what people do and like pick up things for yourself and build your own show as you go.
Oh, for sure. Like you said, you know, learning from the people before you. I mean, Cole is one of those people, you're right. He's just so great to learn from because we could sit and have just a heart to heart hang out in the green room for an hour. And he just kind of feels like a brother or somebody that you met at a party. That's just so fun to talk to. And then he goes out and rocks a crowd and everybody sings every single word back to him. And he comes off stage just as humble as when he walked on it. And that's something to be said. I mean, that's just insane. Like the fact that he's had the career that he's had and can still just really feel like a best friend to the first of three that's a brand new artist, you know?
So what you guys did with Never Till Now, obviously it was on the Already Drank That Beer side A that came out in the fall, right? And then you re-release it with this collab with Brett Young. Talk to me about how you guys connected. Did you know each other before that ask happens?
Yeah, so it was honestly really crazy how all of that came together. I put out Never Till Now. I wrote it with Matt Roy, who also wrote Done for Chris Jansen. And I put it out on my project, didn't single it, didn't really highlight the song at all. It was just one of the songs on the project and beautiful song. People seemed to really love it when it came out. But it wasn't until I posted a TikTok that it went viral, like 40 something thousand people using the song to make videos on TikTok, you know, using it as their first dance songs, their wedding songs. I mean, it was just crazy how this song just like stayed in, I think it was top 50 consumption for 8 months, like absolutely insane. And like no single, I was independent when all of this was happening. So nothing pushing the song. It was just a natural, organic consumption story that was just really, really cool. So
wait, what was the TikTok that like spurred all those, you know, 40,000 first uses and all those, like what was the snippet that set it on
when
fire?
I say it was the most random thing. So I'm super consistent with TikTok. I want to post like once a day. So I was just in my apartment a random Monday and I was like, you know, I want to start highlighting different songs from this project, not just the singles off the project. And so I was in my kitchen in like a big old oversized tee that I slept in the night before and just started making a video, just pointing to the lyrics, you know, the TikTok point where you point to all the lyrics. I just made a random video in my kitchen pointing to the lyrics and I posted it just as like a, you know, just throw something up today just to stay consistent. And it got like 2.something million views like overnight. So absolutely wild how it all came together. Was not expecting that at all. And like, you can never really know with TikToks because you just, you know, you make them, you throw them up, and the ones that you think are going to go viral never do. And it's just kind of one of those things. But yeah, so the song really just went crazy. And so when I wrote the song, I had kind of always heard a duet on it just because it's such a narration song. So I was like, man, it would be so cool for all of these people that are relating to the song and, you know, thinking of this song as their story, to get to hear the other person's perspective on that song as the story. So my producer, Jimmy Robbins, who also produces like so many people in town, we were talking about who'd be a good fit for this song. And he was good friends with Brett at the time, well, still is, and gave him a call and was like, hey man, you know, I'm working with this new artist, Ashley Cooke. And Brett immediately was like, I've heard this song. And he's like, I love this song and I love her voice. Like, I'd love to be on the song. So it was really quick and really cool how it all happened. He came in, recorded the second verse and some amazing harmonies, and It is what it is today.
Okay,
So
that's
really cool.
awesome. This like restless dreamer who doesn't want to be tied down in this song, is that a character? Is that you? Like, is how auto
Definitely me.
it is.
Yeah, and when I wrote the song, I was mid going through a breakup, which obviously reflects in the other songs on this project. Never Till Now is the only love song on this project, and it was pretty calculated because I was like, man, I always love projects that tell a story top to bottom, and it seemed to me like when I wrote it, it was, I'm so tired of this breakup. I'm so tired of going through the kind of love that I can't figure out how to get the right kind of love, how to feel the right kind of love. And so it was a manifestation for me in that song. The kind of love that I want to have at some point in my life. And I'm very much that character in the story. So it's really narration.